gonna get a little closer. So we'll get closer once we get back on the main highway.
We will get closer?
Yeah, I think. The only other highway that we were on heads back to where we were, you know, south where we were from. So I mean, must get closer. It's a ways down there. All right, hold on a sec. Alright, I want my picture. Okay. And look at the road.
It's higher up?
I don't know. We're not gonna. I guess I was hoping for a good view, and this is we got it, I'd say, huh? I don't know if it, the paved roads, according to the map, the paved roads just called kind of loop around and, you know, they loop around eventually head back towards the highway, but these, you know, the gravel roads aren't marked on the, you know, on the state map, so who knows where they end up, you know. They're probably all over the place. That's how they log these spots. These spots are logged, so. All right, someday when we're better off, we'll deliberately come here, this spot, when the rhododendrons are in bloom. Yeah, no worse than Rock Creek.
Yeah, okay, no bathroom.
No bathroom, no water. Driving all this way out here, intending to camp there, and you know, finding out somebody else is there, or being there and having people constantly come expecting to camp there, and you're there. You know what I mean? Try to remember that one corner where we can see that other mountain. I was going to say, I thought that mountain was in the wrong spot because we're to the west of that north-south Highway 26. Well, I guess it kind of does right here. Or maybe it's that mountain over there that has those rocks exposed. I don't know. That one guy we passed had two kayaks. I mean, there must be a lake around here or something.
Sorts of pull-offs
on the road. I was gonna say, what the hell was he doing? Yep, definitely out in the boonies, Tiff. Of course, that's the north facing, whereas the Mount Hood we saw, maybe the other side looks white, because I remember coming on the interstate from Portland and it looked really white, so the other side's probably really white.
If you're the winner, call 541-296-9102 now. Here is the winning number.
But the one that we did.
Should I rip off that? Rip the plastic off? Well, people are gonna fucking do what we did. They're gonna keep camping there because they gotta keep the fucking road open so people can get to the hiking trail. So why not just let the fucking campground be open? Does that make sense?
Or fire. Is there another fire leak?
Yeah. Yes. Still cut the trees down. There seems a lot cut that aren't black, so. Alright, there was a binocular sign there for viewpoint, and I was wondering last night where the viewpoint was. I guess we found it. Had to get your ass way back in there to find it, though.
Time
is it?
Blue Box Pass.
Huh?
Is that Mountain?
Yes, it's the same mountain we saw, just closer up. I guess we really didn't need to go down that road for that view. There it is. Oh, the glacier's on it. Summer ski camp. I have a ski camp in the summer.
Thank you.
Fuck you. I'm not talking to you, of course. Instead of focused in on the bug juice and the fucking I don't think I have to worry about that right now. Hey, there's a hut, or this lodge, or that's where the ski hill is. Now as you can see, the ski lift goes up to the ski hill right on the side of the mountain.
Is that wind I
Chesapeake River. I didn't think I saw anything when we went over the bridge. Probably the other direction where we just forked off the highway. Who knows? It's either snow or it's a cloud. Well, apparently this one's more dormant than the Mountain Rainier is. Mountain Rainier is, of all the ones in the western U.S., Mountain Rainier is the one the most likely to go boom, I guess. Briefly. Yeah, well, by the time we got close, it was fucking fogged over, so. Well, that was the reason why we should have made time to get to it on this trip, because we never actually saw it up close. Nice jacket.